Hi friends, welcome to Botany, the language of plants, and today's topic
Gygnema. We know that Gygnema belongs to class Chlorophyceae, order Gygnematalis, and family Gygnemataceae. Gygnema is a freshwater algae commonly occur on the surface of slow running water or sometimes submerged. In this type, they are attached to stone or other subject or object by the help of rhizoids, which are called heptra. Now, vegetative body structure of Gygnema. Unbranched, filament-like vegetative body thallus, not differentiated into apex or base. Cells are cylindrical and attached end to end and produce this filament. Cells contain two layers, outer thick pectose layer and inner thin cellulose layer. Cells contain two chloroplast and within chloroplast a pyrenoid granule present. Nucleus present in between two chloroplast. Sexual reproduction in Gygnema. In Gygnema, sexual reproduction occurs by production of conjugation tube. There are two type conjugation tube produced. Scalariform conjugation tube and another is lateral conjugation tube. In case of scalariform conjugation tube formation, two filament approach themselves side by side. Protoplast of any cell converted into gametes. So, filament which contain gamete act as a gametangium. Now, small outgrowth produce from each filament. Then, outgrowth enlarge in size and meet with each other. Both filament at that portion covered by mucilaginous sheath. After meet with each other, tube wall dissolve at meeting point and produce a clear passage which is called conjugation tube. Now, there are two conditions present. In condition 1, one gamete motile of a filament, so this is motile gamete and this is non-motile gamete. So motile gamete is active gamete and non-motile gamete is inactive gamete. So here both gametes are equal in size and shape. Okay, so here one is active and another is inactive. So this is morphologically similar but physiologically dissimilar. Okay, so shape are same, size also same. So this is morphological similar. But this gamete active or motile and this gamete inactive or non-motile. So here these are physiological dissimilar. Now condition 2. Both gametes are motile. So, in this case, this gamete motile, so it is also pass from this conjugation tube, and this gamete also motile. So, this is also can pass from this conjugation tube. Okay. Now, zygospore formation. So, in first case, so here scalariform conjugation tube formation and lateral conjugation tube formation. Okay. And here a motile gamete and another gamete is non-motile. Here both are motile. Here same, one is motile gamete and another is non-motile gamete, and here both are motile. Okay. So now in this case, this is non-motile gamete, and here the motile gamete pass from this conjugation tube by amoeboid movement. Okay. Now here also same. Okay. So here non-motile gamete, here motile gamete. Okay. And this is amoeboid movement. Now when both are motile gametes, in that case both gametes come and fuse within this conjugation tube. Okay. Here also both gametes come and fuse within this conjugation tube. Okay. Now after fusion, zygospore produce. So this is about fertilization. Now about zygospore. Zygospore contain three layer: outer cellulose or pectose, in middle chitinized cellulose, and inner layer composed by cellulose. After several months, gamete angel wall destroy and gamete remove from, zygospore remove from this gametangel wall.
Here some picture which I collect from internet, I think which gives you a clear concept about Zygnema. This is a Zygnema cell which cylindrical and contain two chloroplast, two pyrenoid and a nucleus. Next, this is a picture about scalariform conjugation tube and amoeboid movement. And this is the picture about formation of lateral conjugation tube.
Okay. Now, germination of new Zygnema. Zygospore contain a diploid nucleus. By meiosis 1, two nucleus produce, and by meiosis 2, four nucleus produce. Of them, three destroy, only a single nucleus, that is haploid, some protoplasm, and three layer present at last stage of germination. Now outer two layer destroy, only inner layer protoplasm and haploid nucleus stay, and from which new Zygnema produce and chloroplast also generate, and by cell division it increase its size and produce a filament. Okay. So this is all about Zygnema. If you like this video, then press like button, press the bell icon to get notification, subscribe to my channel, and thank you for watching this video.